she came home late at night to find her boyfriend, Ozzy Condi, murdered. She's reluctant to give investigators many details on where she had been that night. Now, as Matt Gutman reports, that decision is about to have some serious repercussions.
Former FBI agent and ABC consultant Steve Gomez has studied the police file
to get the autopsy back, and what does it tell him?
The object that was used to strike Ozzy was some type of long object, such as a bat or a golf club.
Could a relatively petite 5'3", 5'4" woman who weighs 130 pounds, could she have done that?
If she was angry enough, absolutely she could have done this.
We return to the house with Bill Sylvester, an investigator for Kim's defense team. The current residence allowed us inside.
All right, so this is very similar to the way it was, and the argument is this is where the suspect was doing something like this. There were blood spatters found on every wall in this room, ceiling, the floor, this door, and out this door into the garage.
Two things are noticeably absent at the scene. One, murder weapon, which to this day has never been recovered. Two, despite the bloody crime scene, not a speck of blood was found on the cop's prime suspect, Kim Long. Not on those jeans, that black shirt, that belt.
Can you understand why police found that a little suspicious?
Not really.
So clean that something smelled wrong.
Well, that's just because I wasn't there when it happened.
The cops begin to formulate a theory that Kim came home still angry, beat Ozzy to death, disposed of the murder weapon, and cleaned herself up before dialing 911. Bet she's got an alibi witness. At least she thought she did. Jeff Deals, the biker friend who brought her over to his house and into his hot tub that night.
Did anything happen? Was it busy? Did you and Jeff have anything going on?
Well, that's not true. And when Jeff Deals comes in for questioning, his story isn't just different, it's damning.
Did she say anything about, not to say anything about the night before?
She says a cop girl will talk to
you. I said, that's fine.
And then I said, did you tell them? She says, no, I didn't. She said, please don't tell them.
Why lie about having sex with Jeff Dill? You're possibly a suspect for murder.
Yeah, I was just embarrassed. Like, who wants to tell him, oh yeah, by the way, I ran off with some other dude. Having sex with somebody doesn't make you a murderer.
True, but your lover's statements just might. Dill continues to bury Kim, telling police she had a motive. Opportunity. Bill tells cops he dropped him off back at the house much earlier than Kim claimed. He says he knows because he checked the clock when he got home.
I remember a million times on 36. I think that I, going backwards from 136, I would drop her off between 120 and 130.
Long didn't call 911 for help until 209 that morning, leaving up to 49 unaccounted minutes with Ozzy, according to police, giving her ample time to commit the crime and clean herself up. At that moment, the cops are convinced they had their killer.
Did Kim Long ever give a reasonable explanation for what she may have been doing for 50 minutes in the house?
She always denied that it was that long.
But if Kim's a killer, she's a cooperative one. Agreeing to take a polygraph test,
probability of you being accepted is less than 0.01%.
Meaning, according to that technician, there's virtually no chance she's lying. That doesn't stop the cops from pressing her in a follow-up interview during which she breaks into hysterics.
Didn't you tell me to pull this stuff out that night? You got me so much advice to me.
Listening to that interview again, Kim does have one regret.
I didn't know I'd leave. My biggest mistake was ever speaking to them. I had no clue I could get up and just walk out of that room. did that, I would probably look guilty. So I just sat there and just took it. I thought I could convince them.
But she was wrong. 1 month after Ozzy's murder in a snowy, Kim Long finds herself under arrest for bludgeoning to death a man who was once her teenage crush.
I'm gonna wait on time and I'm not gonna get anything off until I have the Lord of Eternity.
When you reviewed the police reports, did anything stand out?
Yeah, we were missing something. I remember going to the attorney and say, this cannot possibly be the whole case. Somebody did it, and the real problem that we have in this case is investigators and the DA developed tunnel vision on one suspect.
Kim's defense team insists that Kim shouldn't have been the only suspect. That's because Ozzy Condi may have been a great guy, he sure had his share of enemies, he was one of them. You hate this guy?
I did, yes.
Meet Joe Bagarski, Kim's ex-husband, the father of her son, the man she dropped like a bad habit when she got reacquainted with Ozzy.
She kicks you out of the house and brings him in to live with your kids. Right. Doesn't look in the same way he moved in.
You know, looking back, I shouldn't have done that. I should have never done that to my children, bringing somebody else in so quickly, kicking my ex-husband out the way I did. You know, it's all wrong. But I was 27 years old and I just wasn't thinking.
So who's this guy? What do you know about him? He moves into your house.
I don't know anything. That's who's helping him out at the time, probably.
Financially.
Yeah.
So if she's helping him out financially, that effectively means that you're helping him out financially.
Right, because I was still giving her money also. And I still love her, you know?
Kim's attorneys claim this laid-back construction worker then became an obsessed cuckold who stalked Kim after she dumped him, hiding in her bushes, peeping in her windows.
That's pretty pissed. Very upset. I mean, how would any other man feel? Like, what kind of guy moves into some house and they're not even divorced?
Well, and if anybody in the world had a motive to kill the man, it's you.
Right. I mean, I'm not the violent type to that extent to kill someone, but I didn't like the situation.
Could Joe, Kim's ex-husband, be the killer? No way, he says. He was home that night with witnesses to prove it. He's not the only suspect Kim floated.
You had a theory of who did it.
Yes.
You said during the interrogation.
Yeah, there was only one person that didn't like us.
Didn't like? Tried burning hatred.
You have any idea who would have done something to who?
Is that?
She's talking about this woman. We've agreed to change her name. We're calling her Cynthia. Kim's defense team has dubbed her Ozzy's jealous ex, a woman scorned. And she calls Kim...
That woman is the devil's child herself.
Devil's child.
Devil's child. There's no doubt in my mind. I know she killed him. And I know she doesn't even care. And it makes me sick.
Cynthia and Ozzy were together for 8 years. They raised...
Dun, 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 dun.